I always got a soft spot for Billy Joel, especially The Stranger and 52nd Street. Those are my two favorite albums. I can sort of live, I mean, Greatest Hits is good to have on CD or digital. But yeah, this is a half-speed mastered of The Stranger. It sounds just amazing. You know, my daughter was living in New York 2 years ago. She was dancing at the Joffrey Ballet School. And my wife and I went down to New York a couple of times to see her dance. And one time when we were down there, Billy Joel was playing at Madison Square, MSG. And I convinced my wife, I was like, come on, let's go see Billy Joel, man. It's classic. It's Billy Joel in his like home stadium, right? And so reluctantly, my wife, because she's always trying to please me, she agreed to go. And we had a great night, and Billy sounded great. He still can sing really well. The crowd was just so into it. And as we were leaving, my wife said she was really happy that I had pressed her to go see Billy Joel, and we had a great night. So The Stranger, Half Speed, it's just on Columbia Red Label, but it's the sound that really matters, right? And I got this used and it's in perfect condition, so I was really happy about that. Now the next one I got is, I'm just gonna take it out of the case. This is the Boss. Go from New York to New Jersey. This is Darkness on the Edge of Town, many consider to be Bruce's best album. Just, I love the photography. Again, a used copy that I didn't pay very much for. Half-speed mastered, Darkness on the Edge of Town. I have seen Bruce in concert. I took my dad for big birthday, maybe his 65th, so maybe a few years ago now, but I mean, the guy just, it's like 3 hours. You start looking at your watch, are we gonna get out of here tonight? Like, this guy's still got another hour of music to play. He's just an incredible giver of music and great album. Also recommend his biography that came out last year. So yeah, as I said, I was in Singapore, and you know, they got a lot of Japanese vinyl over there. Who would have thunked it, right? I mean, you're in the same neck of the woods, I guess. Anyway, I started with, I'll start with this one. This is Neil Young's On the Beach. You know, to many, his best album. Unfortunately, there's no obi on this, but it is in the rice paper sleeve. And it does come with the inserts, with the Japanese and the English lyrics. Even the inside of the jacket's all done. And yeah, it just sounds amazing. Again, this is used and it's just in beautiful condition. And yeah, definitely in my top three Neil Young albums. So On the Beach, I was super pumped to get this. This is my favorite Elvis Costello album. Oh, I should say, I did see Neil Young in concert back in the 90s. I saw Neil Young with Pearl Jam. So, and yeah, Elvis, this is Imperial Bedroom. This is actually my favorite Elvis album. This has the obi. Man Out of Time is on this album, which I've said in other videos, I just don't want to sound repetitive. It's my favorite song. And guess what? I'm going to see Elvis on December 4th. I got tickets to see him in Vancouver. So one person I haven't seen, and I'm really super pumped to get to see him. Now, one band I'll never get to see is Led Zeppelin. This is, again, Japanese pressing of Led Zeppelin 4, or Untitled, or whatever. Came in this great sleeve gatefold with the obi. I mean, what is there to say or not say about Led Zeppelin 4? Just sounds really good. I mean, you can crank this baby and it's just the whole house is shaking, and my wife and daughter are watching The Bachelor upstairs, and you just hear that, you know, intro to rock and roll come on, and yeah, it's awesome. And lastly, the last set, which is playing right now, a little bit of Beatles. So this is the Blue Album. Japanese pressing, unfortunately no obi on this one. It does come with this fantastic book, though. Check this out. So you get the book. It's got all the lyrics in English and Japanese. It's got all those pictures with a lot of extra ones that we never got when we just got the double album. I mean, this is like a 25-30 page book. It's a 20 page book. I like to exaggerate sometimes. 22 pages to be exact. So this is great. You know, the Blue Album, the 67 to 70, just a classic. I remember my dad had this when I was a kid, and you know, he used to play it all the time. And yeah, the Japanese pressings, again, this is used. It's in pretty decent shape. I got this for a good price though, so I'm okay with that. And then we get into my latest passion, and that's collecting the flag series. So, I should do these in sequence. Let's start. I've got Hard Day's Night. And these are absolutely mint. There's not a mark on them. The OBs are all attached. They're all in perfect shape. There's no bent corners. The vinyl looks like it's never being played. So I managed to score Hard Day's Night, Revolver, Rubber Soul. Let's try that again, Edwin. Rubber Soul. Again, complete OB, complete, no bend corners, and Revolver. Same thing, just beautiful. I'll open up Revolver to give you an idea. So you get the, they all come with the insert. Again, English and Japanese lyrics printed on the insert. Just a nice fold out. They all come with the insert. And of course you get the rice paper with a nice curve. These are on the Apple label. Not a mark on them. So this adds now, I've got Sgt. Pepper's and I've got that kind of early, what's it called, early releases. And then last but not least, I got a Let It Be, different series, but still Japanese pressing with the Obi and Let It Be. And this sounds beautiful. I don't really know the significant difference between this green Obi and this is a gatefold. So the OB goes through the gatefold, and this is also on the Apple. Just sounds amazing. This is with the black, with the wax inner sleeve, so you get the protection. And yeah, Let It Be. So yeah, so just a quick update on some great Beatle finds. And you know, you chuck in Billy Joel, Bruce Springsteen, Neil Young, and what else did I have in there? And Elvis Costello. So cheers, guys. Enjoy and happy listening.